Assalamu alaikum. Welcome back after the break. You're watching Towards the Origin in conversation with Shaykh Kazi Lutfur Rahman, who is the respected Imaam and Khateeb of the London Central Mosque and Islamic Cultural Centre, famously known as Regent's Park Mosque. Our today's conversation is Quranic. Thank you to all of you who have joined us through our Facebook page and or through our website, which is chsuk.tv. The repeat of this programme will be broadcasted on the following day, 11 o'clock, next day in the morning, and you will also find us later on our YouTube channel. Should you have any questions, any queries or any feedback, please feel free to email us, and the email address is, you can see it at the bottom of your TV screen, which is towardstheorigin@chsuk.tv. Now, Sheikh, in our first segment, we've discussed about the beauty in the nature, the beauty in human beings, the beauty in the animals. So the various creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has been discussed in the first segment. Now, how does that relate to our program title, The Art or the Quranic Art of It?
Okay. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He called us towards the beauty, and He planted a seed of beauty in our hearts and minds in the Noble Quran and through different verses. Now, when we talk about Islamic art or the art in Islam generally, we are saying that the sense of beauty expressed through different means. অর্থাৎ যে ইসলামিক শিল্প বা শিল্প ইসলামের মধ্যে যেটা যেটাকে বলা হচ্ছে যে আমাদের যে এই 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 যে আনন্দ এবং আমাদের যে যে সৌন্দর্য এটাকে ভিন্নভাবে এক্সপ্রেস করা, এটা ভিন্নভাবে এটাকে প্রমাণ করা, এটাকেই ইসলামিক ফান বা ইসলামিক আর্ট বা আর্ট ইন ইসলাম বলা হচ্ছে। But there is a slightly difference between the art in Islam and probably general art. So the general art, normally people would say, okay, it's mainly for entertainment. Maybe like, you know, there can be other reasons. But one of the reasons for behind the art, but shilpur, my pichoner modde o lokko uddeshyo hocche je binodon mulok ba binodon manushderke anondo ebong anondo dan kora. So it's entertaining in understanding of
or perhaps using the time that people may consider to have free time, they can utilize the entertainment.
But when it comes to the art in Islam, there is always an aim and objective.
But Islam doesn't stop us from being entertained.
Okay, and again, so yes, that's fine. But again, within some sort of like
you mean there is a parameter given.
Yes, yes. Okay. And we mentioned
the current
and this art is whole entire art is about expressing the beauty and happiness.
Now, just to clarify, if our viewers have certain understanding, the Islam obviously allows us to express our happiness
and yes,
and
yes.
joyous
and
moment.
And قل من حرم زينة الله التي أخرج العباد. Allah says, you know, say who prohibits the beauty of Allah and of course the happiness and so this is part of the religion. And إدخال السرور في قلب المسلم صدقة, like putting some sort of happiness in the heart and mind of a Muslim is charity.
So that means anything that we do in our life, jokhoni amra kichu kori, it has to be governed by the Islamic principles
yes,
and
yes,
teaching.
Yes.
Is that correct?
Yes. And finally, Islam and Islam, the art in Islam again will always have an aim and objective, and that's how Muslims from the earliest day used the art or the fen.
What's the aim and objective?
Okay, so aim objective again. First of all, it could be, of course, just the beauty, the sense of beauty itself, but ultimately calling people to the way of Allah, to the creation of Allah, to ma'rifah and to the recognition of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Now, when you say sense of beauty, does it mean that you should appreciate that the creation of Allah is yes. very beautiful and appreciate His existence?
Exactly, yes, yes. It exists. And then, of course, it can be expressed through different forms.
Different
and we'll
mediums.
Mention. Yeah, we'll mention. So now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's talking about, actually, one of the major fan or the art was, at the time, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was the shi'r, the poem.
The poetry. Shi'r,
poetries. Mm-hmm. Right. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the shi'r in Quran al-Kareem. So He says, وَالشُعَرَاءُ وَيَتَّبِعُهُمُ الْغَاوُونَ. He's talking about general poets at that time. So general poets who are not within the way of revelation. So these people, Allah is saying, يَتَّبِعُهُمْ الْغَاوُونَ, misguided people are following the shu'ara.
Now, just to give a little bit of background for our viewers' understanding, that why when you said poetry is because that era when the Quran was revealed, was it known an era of poetry?
Yes, of course, yes. And people really gave a lot of importance in poetries at that
like
time. And literature.
Like today, we have science and technology
yes,
the way it's
adab,
given.
Adab and literature.
So similarly, at that point, in time, poetry and literature was a very top-notch fact.
So الشعراء يتبعهم الغاون, the poets were followed by some of the people who are really, because, you know, sometimes they would waste the time and use just poetry in unnecessary things. Then he said, أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّهُمْ فِي كُلِّ وَادٍ يَهِيمُونَ That didn't you see like that they were roaming in different valleys in Mecca, in the Arab. أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّهُمْ فِي كُلِّ وَادٍ يَهِيمُونَ وَأَنَّهُمْ يَقُولُونَ مَا لَا يَفْعَلُونَ And they say what they do not do. But then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives exceptions. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا Except those who believed in Allah. وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ And those who did the righteous, those who performed the righteous deeds. So not all the shair or not all the poets were condemned by Islam and Quran and Allah. When poetic kobiki kintu Islam and what they condemn Korahani. Ejon Allah Pakrabul Alam, Illa Levina Amanu, Manajara Allah Pakrabul Iman and Chen among Jara Amul Saleh Koreshan. Now we see the noble messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he had actually a personal shair, he had a personal poet. Who would defend him whenever, like the enemies of Islam would attack?
What do you mean by personal poet?
So he had shair. So for example, whenever somebody would make a comment or condemn noble messenger or criticize him, then he would come up and he would defend him through the poetries.
Okay.
So when he kobitar moddome Rasul Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam ke unake Rasul Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam defend korechen ejon unake bola hoye je Rasul Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam personal byaktigoto kobi shair Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam Hassan ibn Thabit radhiyallahu anhu unik jun kintu ottonto guruttopurno sahabi bote he was a great companion of the noble prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam he said in his shair and again you see shair was a type of art which has been used by the Sahaba and the Muslims later and also the literature in general. So he says, وَأَحْسَنُ مِنْكَ لَمْ تَرَقَطْتُ عَيْنِي Talking about the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, saying that there is nobody who witnessed and who observed an individual like you, O Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He's praising him, but at the same time, it's a defense for Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. وَأَحْسَنُ مِنْكَ لَمْ تَرَقَطْتُ عَيْنِي And then he says, وَأَجْمَلُ مِنْكَ لَمْ تَلِدِ النِّسَاءُ There's no mother has ever gave birth to any child like yourself or Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Who is saying Hassan ibn Thabit radiallahu anhu? And then he's saying, خُلِقْتَ مُبَرَّأً مِّن كُلِّ عَيْبٍ That you've been created free from all kind of errors and faults and mistakes and all عَيْب. Mani Allah Pakra Bula Amin, apnagi etto shundro be sishti kore chen, ja apna mudde kuno عَيْب nei, خُلِقْتَ مُبَرَّأً, sishti kota babi kuno عَيْب nei, min kulli عَيْب. كَأَنَّكَ قَدْ خُلِقْتَ كَمَا تَشَاءُ As if you're created just the way you wanted to be created. মানে আপনি এমনভাবে সৃষ্টি হয়েছেন যেরকম আপনি হয়তো চেয়েছিলেন আপনার আপনার ইচ্ছেই ছিল যে আপনি এরকম সৃষ্টি হবেন if you're created you know the way you have been created Allah created you you know as كأنك قد خلقت كما تشاء so it's a type of art we can see in the shi'r and then we see also Muslims have used the shi'r in many many different throughout the whole entire Islamic history people like for example Imam al-Busayri, you find people like, even like in the Asian subcontinent, like Muhammad Iqbal, like the famous Sha'ar, Muhammad Iqbal, he did a lot for also Islam and for the service of Islam.
Now, ekhane proshno uthe, sadharonto amra ei je shilpo kala ba ei je poetry, literature, language, amader dharona hocche. General understanding, it's not associated directly with the Quran Sunnah. And why we say that is also we do a lot of see Quran competition, we do hear about it, we do hear about a lot of other competition. But how often do we hear Muslim scholars or Muslim organization encouraging the art of literature, language, or poetry, and so on and so forth?
And you're right. Actually, that literature is one of the methods which were actually used to spread the message of Islam. And some of the biggest scholars of Islam were high in the language. And Quran gave a lot of importance in language. And this is the reason why Quran itself is like a masterpiece. It's unique. It's unparalleled. There's nothing can match the language and the standard of Quran al-Karim. Hence, it's a miracle of Noble Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam.
We do know the Quran has got verses which rhymes, the verses has poetry element to it. Now, the other aspect why I wanted to touch on that is because people's understanding or general people's understanding, these are associated with secular education and understanding.
No. So this is the reason why we're mentioning here today that shi'r, the poetries, were used as a form of da'wah. And Sahaba radiallahu anhum and the early Muslim, they used poems to defend Islam and to spread the message of Islam.
Now, when you say form of da'wah, er ortho ki kibhabe apni da'wah dicchen?
Ortho apni jokhon, acha apni shunen. Bangladeshi jatiyo kobi kobi nazrul. আজ পর্যন্ত কিন্তু কবি নজরুলের কবিতা কিন্তু পড়া হচ্ছে
জি আচ্ছা
এবং এবং যে নাসিক যে আমরা বলি ইসলামিক সঙ্গীতের মধ্যে কিন্তু কবি নজরুলের গান গাওয়া হচ্ছে এবং এই গানের মধ্যে কি কতটুকু যে মানে মানুষের ভিতরে যে যে ইনফ্লুয়েন্স করছে প্রভাব ফেলছে এটাকে আমরা দেখতে পাচ্ছি
মানে তার মানে হচ্ছে আপনি দাওয়াত যেটা বলতে চাচ্ছেন হচ্ছে যে লিরিক্স গুলি কি আছে যে রাইটিং গুলি কি আছে এর মধ্যে আল্লাহর ওয়াহদানিয়াত তাওহীদ বা সব কিছু বর্ণনা করা হচ্ছে
দিস পোয়েটস দে ইউজ দ্য পাওয়ারফুল ল্যাঙ্গুয়েজ দ্য পাওয়ারফুল ওয়ার্ড যখন কবি নজরুল বলেন মসজিদেরই পাশে আমায় কবর দিও ভাই যখন আমি মুয়াজ্জিনের আজান আজান শুনতে পাই পাওয়ারফুল ওয়ার্ডস এন্ড দেন ইউ গট মেনি আদার কবি নজরুলস এন্ড আদার্স নট অনলি জাস্ট
ইন আদার ওয়ার্ডস দ্য মেসেজ ইজ বিকজ থ্রু দোজ পোয়েট্রি you can establish the akhlaq, you can talk about
exactly.
the tawheed,
because,
you can
because,
talk about
because
the other.
Because these have huge influence in the people, in minds, people's mind and heart. So so after talking about shi'r, also there's another type of art in Islam, which also Islam took it very important, especially in contemporary era, and that's the art of Qur'an. So Qur'an has been recited in many different tunes, and this is known as Qur'an al-Mujawwad. So amader Qur'an Sharif, jokhon amra tilawat kora hoy, কোরআন সে ভিন্নভাবে তেলাওয়াত করা হচ্ছে একটা টাইপ হচ্ছে মুজাওয়াদ কোরআন অর্থাৎ যেটা স্লো মোশনে পড়া হচ্ছে এটাকে রিসিটেশন করা হচ্ছে সো দ্যাট ইজ কল কোরআন আল মুজাওয়াদ এন্ড ইফ ইউ সি দ্য স্কলার দ্য রিসাইটার্স অফ দ্য নোবেল কোরআন দ্য জায়ান্টস এন্ড দ্য আমারিক অফ কোরআন দে প্রুভ দ্য কোরআন ক্যান অ্যাকচুয়ালি অ্যাট্রাক্ট পিপল টু ইসলাম এন্ড দের আর পিপল দ্য আই নো বিকেম মুসলিম বাই লিসনিং টু কোরআন এন্ড ওনলি অলসো পিপল হু বিকেম ইসলাম রিলিজিয়াস প্র্যাকটিসিং বাই লিসনিং টু কোরআন
সাম পিপল আর সে দ্যাট মাই আই ডোন্ট স্পিক আরবিক আরবিক ইজ নট মাই ল্যাঙ্গুয়েজ সো হাউ ক্যান আই বি অ্যাট্রাক্টেড
নো কোরআন হ্যাজ অ্যান এফেক্ট ডোন্ট ইউ সি লাইক আই হ্যাভ জাস্ট সিন লাইক রিসেন্টলি উই সি দের আর লট অফ কোরআনিক programs even happening in Bangladesh and other parts of the world, Muslim world. And people don't understand actually, but you see how it moves people, the Quran and the recitation of the Noble Quran. Now, of course, the art of Quran, this is known as maqamat in Arabic. The scholars of tajweed, sorry, scholars of, or the reciters of the Noble Quran, they use different tunes to really beautify the Noble Quran. কোরআন শরীফকে সৌন্দর্য করার জন্য ভিন্ন মাকামাত ওনারা ব্যবহার করেছেন ফান ব্যবহার করেছেন এই জন্য উই সি লাইক ফর এক্সাম্পল পিপল লাইক মোহাম্মদ শেখ মুস্তাফা ইসমাইল মোহাম্মদ রিফাত শেখ মোহাম্মদ আলী বান্না শেখ আল হুসারি শেখ আব্দুল বাসিত আব্দুল সামাদ দিজ আর সাম অফ দ্য জায়ান্টস হু হ্যাভ প্রুভড দ্যাট কোরআন ইজ অ্যাকচুয়ালি এ সোর্স অফ অ্যাট্রাকশন টু দ্য পিপল অফ দ্য ওয়ার্ল্ড এন্ড উই সি লাইক এভরি রিসাইটার ইজ রিসাইটিং কোরআন এন্ড দেয়ার ইজ ডিফারেন্ট বিউটি ইন ইট And so therefore, it has been developed as a fan, as an art. Now, I cannot come and just say, this is all haram. Because again, Islam does not prohibit the beauty. Now, it can be considered as something wrong if it goes against the tajweed. If it goes against the teaching of, or the ahkam, or the rules and regulation of tajweed, then we say it's not allowed. Or even if it's exaggerated.
Or
someone's just like singing. The Quran is like singing.
Okay, now there is another understanding or thought process behind it. Nowadays, we see people are, we can't talk about people's intention whatsoever. We can't comment on that. We have to be careful on that. However, we do notice there is a huge now fan following systems that are available through social media network, attracting people through their voices. Now, only Allah knows what the intention is.
Yes.
Now, because of that, now the other problem we have is people, instead of understanding the subject, they're concentrating on who the Qari is and how great is the Qara'ah.
Excellent.
Rather than the tarjama or the understanding or
amazing.
The meaning of the Qur'an.
Good point. And so this is something we need to point out. Yes, it has been used as an art. And if someone recites with respect and honor and with haiba, সম্মানের সাথে
পড়তে
হবে, উইথ আদবের সাথে পড়তে হবে. আমরা কোনো কোনো কারিকে দেখি কোনো কোনো কারিকে দেখতে পারি যে উনি যেমন উনি হি ইজ প্লেয়িং উইথ দ্য কোরআন এন্ড হি জাস্ট লাইক এ নর্মাল আর্টিস্ট লাইক ইউনো হু ইজ নট
মানে লাইক এ সিঙ্গার অর সামথিং
ইয়েস ইয়েস সো এই জন্য আমরা যখন কোরআন শরীফ পড়া হবে এটা হাই বা আদবের সাথে পড়তে হবে উই হ্যাভ টু রিসাইট
ফলোইং দ্য রুলস এন্ড রেগুলেশন
অফ কোর্স দ্য রুলস এন্ড রেগুলেশন কাম ফার্স্ট বিফোর এভরিথিং মাখারিজ দ্য প্রোনাউন্সিয়েশন রুলস এন্ড রেগুলেশন বিফোর এভরিথিং এন্ড দেন দ্য টুন কামস ইয়েস বিকজ দ্য জিন দ্য বিউটি বাট দ্য টুন হ্যাজ টু বি অ্যাগেইন কন্ট্রোলড বাই দ্য রুলস এন্ড রেগুলেশন
সাবকন্টিনেন্ট কালচার আমরা দেখেছি বা দেখি আপনি ইমাম হয়তো আপনি আরো বেশি দেখবেন যে মানুষ তাজউদের আগে কিন্তু তারা তাদের টোন বা টিউনকে দ্য মেলোডিকে প্রাধান্য বেশি দেয়
জি এন্ড দিস ইজ সামথিং লাইক উই হ্যাভ মিসআন্ডারস্ট্যান্ডিং উইচ ইজ ইফ সামওয়ান রিসাইটস কোরআন বিফোর উই হ্যাড দ্যাট ইফ সামওয়ান ক্যান রিসাইট ইন স্পিড ফাস্ট এন্ড উই স্টিল হ্যাভ সাম পিপল
এক্সপ্রেস ট্রেইন
ইয়া দ্যাটস লাইক সামথিং সিন অ্যাজ ভেরি এক্সপার্ট বাট নাও অফ কোর্স পিপল সামটাইমস সে ও হাউ beautifully recited. But people obviously, many of us, we don't even know the rules of tajweed. So how can we say which one is better and which is not better? But generally, we're speaking about the art of Quran. Again, it must not be exaggerated. It must be recited with adab. Adab, ebong ihtiram, ebong shammaner sathe porte hobe, ebong mane barbari kora jabe na jokhon amra ei je kontho gulo ke amra byabohar
korbo. What about the intention of the qari?
Again, intention, of course, it has to be. This is primary, that it has to be to, first of all, to please Allah, and secondly, to attract people to the Quran and to the way of Allah.
And also to appreciate that Allah has blessed him with the melody,
at the same time, sense of beauty, that the enjoying the beauty of Quran. That's fine too.
Ebang eta ekta niyamat kintu Allah shobar kintu sur sundor noy.
Yes. Now again, so after Quran, talking about Quran al-Karim, we've got another type of fan and art that has been used again, which is anashid al-Islamiyah. So again, you see Islamic nasheeds.
Shangit.
Ebang I must say that it has been used hugely in the Muslim world, especially in the context. And even it was used before as well. Not only it's not just new, even at the time of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, it was used as well. Because Tala' al-Badru alayna, it wasn't done now. It was done when Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam migrated.
But later on, subcontinent, they prohibited the singing itself.
Yes, they prohibited not all the singings, but due to reasons again. But okay, we can't go to that discussion, there's not much time. But but generally, yes, some did, some didn't. But they had, some had reasons. But I think generally the Islamic shangit, Islamic songs, were not prohibited if it's just Islamic songs. But now, talking about like Tala' al-Badru alayna, it was done actually at the time of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And it's an Islamic nasheed. So the children in Medina al-Munawwara greeted and welcomed Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam by saying Tala' al-Badru alayna min thaniyat al-wada'i.
With melody and tune.
Of course, in tune. Now, these anashid al-diniya and Islamic shangit, Islamic songs, again, have developed in the contemporary era. And it has been used as a form of dawah. And I know that people actually who were completely in normal sort of music, but then anashid attracted them and brought them to a different...
Now, because you've mentioned the word music there, now we have also other issue here. Now, with nasheed, we say it's an Islamic shangit, by Islamic songs. Now, we are adding musical instrument to it. So we have to be careful on, obviously, when it comes to giving a fatwa live on air.
Yes.
But just how would you advise our viewers?
So I would say generally the scholars of Islam have three major positions in music when it comes to using the
musical instruments
in nasheeds and in other things, even in like normal sort of poems and songs which are normal songs, like, you know, talking about describing country or like describing a land,
patriotic nature.
Yes. Scholars of Islam have three major positions. Number one, that it should not be used any form. And there is a number of scholars on that. And they have the evidences to say that.
And just to say that, there are also other opinions as well.
I'm coming, yes. And then I said three major positions. So that's one. Then you've got another position that they say, okay, we can use the drum only, the one-sided daf, which is like the light beat, and which is done like with respectful manner. So that can be used. But then you've got another group of scholars who went a bit further, and they said, like, you know, it can be used as long as there's not any bad words, and it's not like kind of like, you know, taking people to the wrong line.
Okay.
And so this is three major positions. But again, to me, I would say, like, if someone can avoid it, it's good, but daf is fine. Daf is okay, but if someone can avoid, then that's better. Because sometimes I listen to some of the nasheed artists, mashallah, their voice is so beautiful that it doesn't need anything else. So anyway,
thank you for clarifying.
This is another discussion, by the way, and inshallah, perhaps we can discuss another day. But there also art also has been used as written art, like for example, calligraphy has been used as a form of dawah. Why people go to, for example, Turkey to see the beautiful artwork and the decoration that Muslims built and done and constructed.
Calligraphy, painting,
calligraphy, yes,
and a lot of things.
And different things. Go to Spain, for example, Granada. Why people go to see the Alhambra, the beautiful artwork of the Muslims in the Andalusian time. Amra dekhte parchi, jokhon amra India jai. Taj Mahal ke sthapon korechilen. Who built Taj Mahal? Shah Jahan. Shah Jahan was a Mughal emperor, Mughal Muslim leader. Taj Mahal ke sthapon korechen. Ebong people go from all over the world to see the Taj Mahal.
Beauty. People, if they are blessed with talent, utilize it in the direction that has been prescribed by the Quran and Sunnah.
That's right. And then you have, for example, even here in London, sometimes people come to London Central Mosque that we're in. It's a beautiful artwork which was done by Frederick Gribbard, a British architect, in 1977, and he constructed the building. It's beautiful. beautiful as well and part of British heritage now, London Central Mosque. And then you find in the Muslim world like Al-Hamra, Turkey, Morocco, Egypt.
And even in non-Muslim world, there are things to appreciate when it comes to architecture.
Definitely. And again, like when there's a good art, it doesn't know whether it's Muslim or non-Muslims, because it can be done by non-Muslims too. And really, non-Muslims done also many, many good. And I told you, London Central Mosque is designed by a non-Muslim.
Mashallah.
It's not a Muslim. Frederick Gibbard was a British architect, and he's the one who designed London Central Mosque. So, and then you see Medina al-Munawwara. So, like, look at the beautiful building of Medina al-Munawwara, one of the best, most fascinating building ever you can see. Again, it's artwork. Now, this art can be used in different forms, calligraphy, like sketching the nature and different things, and expressing the beauty.
And in today's time, we also have something called as eco-friendly or environmental-friendly architectural designs that are available that we can utilize our masajid.
And exactly. And so we need to really beautify. We cannot avoid the beauty because Islam gave the importance to the beauty. And Muslim scholars Dani and Islam actually attracted people through calligraphy and other different forms and even like different written artwork. And even the zakhrafat we see like in the Muslim, like the buildings that constructed by Muslims, like Taj Mahal, for example, like Al-Hamra, the Hagia Sophia, and major mosques like Al-Azhar Masjid and Masjid Amr ibn al-As in Egypt, and major mosques in, for example, in Morocco and other parts
of the world. So that means it's a field that is encouraged, and we should nurture our child.
Yes, and we need to encourage.
Amra shobai ki doctor engineer banate kintu khubi very excited.
No, but we need to see what talent the child has, and then use them in the right way. And I think Islamic art has played a vital role to actually spread. And as I said, it can be through Quranic recitation, it can be through nasheed, it can be through written, it can be through even constructing a building. It can be through different things and many other forms. And I hope this is enough for today.
Now, Jazakallah khair for expressing those thoughts and sharing your thoughts as well. Mm-hmm. And I believe it's very, very enlightening. And I've learned a lot as well.
Allah ibarak.
And thank you once again for coming to the program.
Wa jazakumullah khairan.
With this, my dear viewers, we have come to the conclusion of our tonight's discussion. Sheikh has clearly mentioned about certain things, perhaps many of us, including myself, we may have misconception. Islam encourages the field of art. Islam encourages the beauty of architecture, design, fashion, but it has to be done, or it needs to be done in a way that has been prescribed, mentioned in the Quran and Sunnah. Yes, anything that Islam also encourages us to have fun and enjoyment. There's room for that. However, anything that is considered to be excessive, anything that is considered to be too much, must always be avoided. And as usual, whenever we're in doubt, we have confusion, we have questions in our mind, we need to get in touch with qualified scholars, qualified mediums, and perhaps then get our understanding better, clear our doubts, and then work on educating our own self, perhaps to spread the message of Islam. And finally, one day we all have to leave the world. It's what we have left behind. We know today a lot of janazas has been prayed. One of the famous known scholars of our community have passed away. But it's what he has left, or what do we leave? What do we learn from it? It's when we leave this world, what have we left behind? And these are one of the greatest examples, as Sheikh has mentioned, about the arts, literature, poetry, that people, when they read after we have left this world, that if people have benefited, that will be the sadqa jariyah. And inshallah, may Allah give us the ability to nurture these talents, to understand, and perhaps to propagate the message of Islam through these work of art. With this, we come to the conclusion of our tonight's discussion. Inshallah, we'll be discussing a new topic in our new episode. Until we meet again, subhanakallahumma bihamdik, nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Jazakallah khair, Sheikh.